name is Tommy.
I'm Prince Al.
And I'm John Law, and you're watching the Musicians Rock Network.
We're Statues of Liberty.
Oh, yeah. Right.
And
right, rock ready? Hard and keep it mellow.
Metal!
With some metal.
Good one.
Slags. Honky Toast.
Played with us every so often.
Played with Porn Rock a lot. A lot.
Yeah.
We played with, who was some of those other, Pop Mafia? Did you ever see us with Pop Mafia? There was a whole Queens. We used to, no, at the Continental we played
with. Was
that
at Castle?
Yeah. It smells real good, dude.
Oh, and then we played with all the Jersey bands, like Atomic Bitchwax.
Oh, yeah. Of course.
F.D. Toss.
I don't know, Japanese bitches, maybe that's
like. That's funny. Now I got to think
about history. There's a lot of it.
Yeah. So we've been riding up and down these roads for quite a while.
So Statues of Liberty's got an alternate history.
Statues of Liberty has a big, long...
It was the previous incarnation.
Basically, what happened was, we were Banana Fish Zero. We rode up and down these roads. We had a song called, and basically, it was Annihilated Up and Down the Coast. You want problems, we got the most. And that sums up Banana Fish Zero. We just, we were a car with three wheels. We were an accident waiting to stop happening. And so finally the accident, finally we had to stop the accident from happening. And what did we do? We nailed, we cleaned up our...
The fire burns out.
We cleaned up some stuff, and we got back on, and I think that we're, Statues is in a way, more fierce, less out of control. But the thing is, the out of control of Banana Fish Zero is beautiful.
Oh, yes.
Like when I listen to the out of control of Banana Fish Zero,
you heard a little bit of it tonight.
Capture
party
it.
Record.
Yes, exactly.
That's
your most ironic song.
And there's a few
ever.
Other songs tonight.
Which one?
He'll be the one to tell you which one.
Oh yeah, I know.
So hilarious.
You won't do it.
Yeah.
Well, the video for the party record was hysterical.
If you dig on the internet somewhere and put in BFZ party record, you should be able to pull up the video.
Yeah, you'll pull up two good videos to see from Banana Fish Zero, our party record, and We Got the Right. We Got the Right's great. It was filling CBGBs, and that's a classic BFZ night. If you go check out We Got the Right by Banana Fish Zero, you'll see...
So you guys used to pack places at 4 o'clock in the morning.
We had a great
time of the night.
We had a great big party. And you know what it was? Once again, it was a party of smiling people. I don't think I ever saw a fight at a Banana Fish Zero crowd. Everyone was all hugs, but everyone was just getting rocked.
Well, that holds true the same like tonight or any place that you go. I mean,
you know, we're celebrating sex and drugs and all that stuff, but the fun side of it.
Right.
Not the I'm gonna get fucked up and kick your ass. It's the, I'm going to get fucked up.
Because nobody's really getting out of control and everything. They're actually enjoying themselves.
Absolutely, yeah. Yeah, you know, that's the part. That's, you know, it's celebrating, like, out of control, smiles.
That's why I stated earlier, it's a side of rock and roll that I haven't seen that much in this mainstream original scene. You just don't see that kind of energy and that kind of show like you put on tonight.
Good. I mean, that's great. But I think it's not
I think it's harder to do.
It's,
I mean, don't get me wrong, there's bands out there that do that, but
it's
harder, much harder to do.
It's,
you know,
a lot of negative
what's
draw.
Fun about playing with Prince Hal and Hitomi is it's genuine. It's like genuine, like there's not an act. We don't dress up for our show. There's not an act. There's not a, hey, Prince Hal, let's wear black tonight or something like that. It's so all the entertainment's coming from our songs and what our songs are talking about. You know, that's, and then you feed off the crowd. You know what I mean? You see who's smiling, you start singing to them. Someone who's not smiling, you point them, you know, you like...
You can get them going.
Yeah, you start singing to them, you find out what's irking them, and then irk them some more until they realize that you're a joker, you know? And then everybody's having fun, you know?
Oh, yeah.
You sing, like, the guy who's pissed off, you sing about his mom for a little bit, looking at him. No, I'm serious, it works every time. They love that. People come to kick ass, and then you're kind of like, you know, I'm in love with your mother, man. You know, and next time they're like, hey, this guy's kind of funny, you know?
try to hear a song like Jiggle Bum and not smile.
Yeah, right.
You can't. I mean...
You want to sing it to us?
I don't know the words well enough.
That's how.
How does that song go?
Well, it starts out with, I like big ladies. butts. I like the girls you call sluts. I like them saucy with gravy and juice. I'm playing duck, duck, goose. It's like the hole in the dike. I got my thumb in a plum. I gotta get my fingers out before I jiggle bum bum.
Yes, sir.
That's classic.
There it goes. There's more. Do we have that on the internet? You know what? I think we'll have to put that on the internet.
I used to have it on the MySpace door.
As statues or as BFC? No, no, BFC didn't play.
No, but you, I don't. I haven't been to your website for a while.
The MySpace page for statues? I think you guys threw it on there.
The song is. Yeah. The song is on our. Yeah. The song is on the MySpace page. Jiggle Bomb's on MySpace page. But
a video?
We have to make. So any of you gents out there that have a big jiggly bum that want to star in our video. Because we want to be different. You know, ladies jiggly bums all over the place. You see that all the time. We want to see some nice men jiggly bums.
Where do you see a lot of your music taken from? What influences?
Oh.
I saw a little bit of Green Day in there.
What are our influences? Yeah, well, I mean, I like bands like, you know what? I love 80s hardcore. But I don't write 80s hardcore, but I love, what I really love about the 80s hardcore scene was the work ethic, like, do it yourself,
right.
You know, and the bands, you know, all the bands I love, you know, they probably sold 5,000 albums their whole career, you know. Now everybody says, oh yeah, I went and saw Bad Brains, yeah, but the thing is where were you when I saw them, because there wasn't that many people out there, you know what I mean, it was like, so,
except
you know,
Rage Against the Machine, they seem to
yeah,
make
Rage it
a
Against
bigger.
The Machine's not a 80s hardcore
no.
band.
Early 90s.
Bad Brains is, Angry Samoans are, Circle Jerks are, DOA, all those bands. They were great bands, you know?
Yeah.
Like, even later it was the Cro-Mags and Agnostic Front and all those bands. Those were great bands. They were really fun. The only thing that happened to me with those kind of bands is violence kind of crept in. And I like the fun stuff, you know? I like, you know, let's see. Let me think of a band that I really, you know. Oh, I got it. You want to know who someone I emulate is Andrew WK.
Okay.
Andrew WK is a good guy. He's nice to everybody. He's a genuine guy,
right?
Yeah, he runs Santos Party House. But I mean, you know, I'm not friends with Andrew WK. I don't know him. But every time I see him, he's genuine. He's nice. He's like showing the love, and then he gets up there and he rocks. Shows everybody a good time. It's great. So, you know.
Yeah. That.
There's a lot of influences, you know.